ladies and gentlemen, would you give a lovely big round of applause for Keith Beckingham. Keith, it's all yours.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It really is a great personal pleasure to be here tonight playing for you. It's always a great pleasure to play the Hammond organ, but it's also a great thrill to play this beautiful BBC theatre organ. I hadn't played it until this afternoon, and it brought back memories because, as I'm sure all of you know, that, of course, it was installed in the Empress Ballroom-Blackpool. And many, many moons ago, I was driving up to Blackpool on business. And it was, well, to tell you how long ago it was, they hadn't even thought of the M6. And so it took like all day to get there in a very small car. And as soon as I got there, I checked into my hotel, and I think within less than 10 minutes, I was in the Empress Ballroom listening to this very organ in the very capable hands, of course, of Horace Finch. So today was a very special day for me to have the chance to come along and play it for the first time. I'm not here to talk, I'm here obviously to play, and I've tried to choose a balanced program of perhaps some of the music that we used to play when we did the broadcasts. Anybody remember the 10 o'clock broadcasts on the theatre organs? Those were the days, weren't they? Right, well anyway, some music. It was always customary in those days to start with a selection, and this was in fact, I think, the selection I played on my first broadcast from the Granada Tooting. Music of Ivan Novello from the Dancing Years.
Thank you.
Thank you. From the music of Ivan Novello, we go to the music of Ernest Tomlinson, a tune that I'm sure you'll have heard. It's the sort of tune you hear on the light music played by orchestra. Again, one of those sort of tunes we often used to play on the 10 o'clock broadcast. Rather nice little tune, and it's called Little Serenade. Thank you. Again, something in the quieter mood, this time by Trevor Duncan. This tune was originally the theme from a Francis Durbridge television serial called The Scarf, and a very haunting melody, and it's called... These are all girls tonight, aren't they? This one, we had the girl from Ipanema, now we're going to have the girl from Corsica.
Thank you.
Now, music in waltz time, some of the lovely waltzes written by the late, great Noel Coward.
Thank you. short while ago I had to play in Australia, and I was asked to play one particular tune. I worked out an arrangement for it, which was originally designed for the Hammond, but to try and play it on the pipe organ. It's a tune I'm sure you're bound to know. It's called Feelings. There have been so many well-known, very brilliant and talented theatre organists, and I'm sure we all have our own favourites. One of my favourites was the late, great Jackie Brown. I loved his very big, lush American style of playing, and I had the pleasure of knowing Jackie quite well, and it's very sad that he's not with us. And I think as a tribute to Jackie, I'd like to play you one or two of the tunes that every time he would sit down at a lovely WurliTzer like this, he would play. So here's a little musical tribute to Jackie Brown. Thank you. It's a bit like Memory Lane tonight, playing on a pipe organ. It reminded me of so many things. For example, the first time I ever saw a theatre organ was when I was going to a cinema in Croydon and watching the film, and when the tabs closed, why then I heard this glorious sound and I saw this wonderful console appear into view with the spotlight on. It was played by an organist called Molly Forbes, and Molly played this wonderful, it was a four-manual Compton in the Davis Theatre, Croydon, and I think that set me on my way to want to become a cinema or theatre organist. I think I was about 15, 20 years too late, but nevertheless, short time after that, I had the opportunity to start to play in cinemas, which was a wonderful experience, and I always remember the first selection I heard Molly Forbes play, and I must admit I borrowed it from her to play on the Granada circuit. And in those days, we used to like to involve the audience in the organ interlude, and we devised this idea of the spot the tune competition, because all the tunes in this medley have the word blue in their title, and I'm sure already you can start thinking of all the, you know, hundreds, millions probably of tunes written with blue in. So we would have this little spot the tune competition, and the idea would be that I would play the selection, and the first person to get to the manager's office with the correct list would be given a box of chocolates. Now, that was fine, and we set out with high hopes, but of course, at that particular time, the cinema business was beginning to go into rather a down period, And so things got a little bit tight. And so the manager, when we had a poor attendance, would come up to me and say, "Tell you what, Keith, look, put in one they won't know tonight, then we won't have to give the chocolates away." So, anyway, such is the commercial life of music. But I'm going to play you the selection. I'm going to include, incidentally, the one that you may not know the title of. It's a beautiful tune. It's the title of which is Little Girl Blue. We're not giving the chocolates away tonight, that's why I told you. But here we go with the selection which I call Out of the Blue. Thank you.
Thank you.